salvation. So the word of God convicts man of sin. Tapos tingnan po natin sa following passages. Isaiah chapter 59 verses 1 to 2 says, "But your iniquities have separated you from God. Your sins have hidden his face from you, so that he will not hear." Also in Romans chapter 3 verse 23, sinulat po ni Apostle Pablo, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." Also in Romans chapter 6 verse 23, he wrote, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." At isinulat din po ni James, sa James chapter 1 verse 21, "Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word," yung salita ng Diyos, "planted in you, which can save you." So, convicting man of sin would ensure two things, mga kapatid. First, God is no respecter of persons. Pakitignan niyo po sa Romans chapter 2, verse 11. Pakigamit po yung mga Bibles ninyo, mga kapatid, sa tablet, sa cellphone, sa printed copy ninyo, sa inyong dala. Romans chapter 2, verse 11, "For God," sabi dito, "does not show favoritism." Kasi nga po, di ba, the gospel is for all. Siya naminili na aalokin niya ng kaligtasan. The gospel is for all. God is no respecter of persons. He does not show favoritism. And number two, man can freely choose to obey the gospel or not obey. Diba, meron po tayong free will, meron tayong choice. So, tingnan po natin sa Acts chapter 2, verse 40. In Acts chapter 2, verse 40, it's written, "With many other words, he warned them, and he pleaded with them, save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Also, in Acts chapter 13, verse 46, "Then Paul and Barnabas answered them boldly, 'We had to speak the word of God to you first, since you rejected.'" Hindi niyo po, ano? Pwede talaga siyang i-reject ng tao kasi may choice yung tao to reject. "Since you rejected and do not consider yourselves worthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles." In many New Testament texts, when the gospel was preached, ano po ang nangyari? Yung mga nakarinig na tao, it pricked their hearts. Tapos, they obeyed the gospel. Kasi di ba many of them were guilty of murdering our Lord Jesus Christ, no? Guilty sila of many sins. Okay, pricked their hearts, and then they obeyed the gospel. Kapag tinanggap at sinunod ng isang tao ang ebanghelyo, ay magkakaroon po ng conversion. Conversion means a turning from and a turning to. It is the process of salvation. Through man's response of faith, di ba po kapag narinig ng tao yung ebanghelyo, kapag tinanggap niya ito, he will believe, he will have faith, magre-repent siya, ipoconfess niya si Lord Jesus Christ as the Son of God, and then he will be baptized for the remission of sin. Pagkatapos po, his or her focus, yung mind niya, yung allegiance niya nagbabago, allowing God's word to change his or her condition. So ano na po yung nangyayari sa condition niya kapag sumunod siya sa gospel? From being lost to being found. From being separated to God to being reconciled to God. From being unforgiven to being forgiven. From being unsaved to saved. From being a non-Christian to being a Christian. So tayo pong lahat na naging Kristiyano, na-convert tayo dahil sa salita ng Diyos, na itinuro at ibinahagi sa atin. Wala naman po siguro dito na naging Kristiyano na sasabihin niya na hindi ko kinailangan yung salita ng Diyos para ma-convert ako. Wala naman po siguro dito sa atin na gano'n. Kasi po, kung wala po ang salita ng Diyos, ay hindi tayo naging Kristiyano ngayon. Nalaman na po natin na in the conviction and conversion of sinners, the Holy Spirit works through God's Word. This is the purpose of the record of the Gospel of Christ. Pakitingnan po natin isa-isa sa ating mga Bibles, mga kapatid. So, sa Luke chapter 8, verse 11, Jesus declared that the seed of the kingdom is the Word of God. And that seed must be planted in a good and honest heart. Diba po yung katanggap, dapat meron siyang mabuti. An honest na puso. Para yung salita ng Diyos ay mananatili dito, it will grow, and it will bear fruit for the kingdom. Tapos tingnan din po natin sa John chapter 5, verse 24. Truly, truly, I say to you, he who hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and will not be judged but has crossed over from death to life. Tapos tingnan din po natin sa John chapter 6, verse 63. It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and are life. So the Holy Spirit produces life through the Word. He gave inspired writings. Without the Word of God, there is no life. And also in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, the Word of God is living, active, and sharper than any two-edged sword, and able to judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart. Also in James chapter 1, verse 18, nakasulat po, in the exercise of His will, He brought us forth by the word of truth. And in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 23, for you have been born again, not of seed, which is perishable, but imperishable, that is true, the living and enduring word of God. So to further show how the Holy Spirit saves sinners, let us read the following testimonies from the Bible. So unahin po natin yung the testimony of our Lord Jesus. Then po natin sa Matthew chapter 28, verses 18 to 20. At ako, very familiar po tayo dyan, di ba? Kasi ginagamit po natin yan, usually kapag tayo ay nag-door knocking, saka nag-share ng Evangelion, ang salita ng Diyos sa mga tao. So in Matthew chapter 28, verses 18 to 20, then Jesus came to them and said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age. Susunod po yung Mark chapter 16, verses 15 to 16. Ang madalas din po natin yung ginagamit kapag tayo ay nag-door knocking, nag-share ng gospel sa iba at nagtuturo sa mga tao. He said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. And in Luke chapter 24, verses 45 to 48, pakitignan niyo po, then he opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. He told them, this is what is written, the Messiah will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached. In his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem, you are witnesses of these things. So, susunod po, the testimony of the examples in the book of Acts. Marami-rami po ito, pero ito po ang patunay na the Holy Spirit saves sinners through the gospel. So, tingnan muna po natin yung sa Acts chapter 2, verses 37 to 41. Ang dami pong na-convert during the Pentecost. Ilan sila po? 3,000. Basahin po natin. When the people heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and other apostles, "Brothers, what shall we do?" Peter replied, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The promise is for you and your children, for all who are from home, for all whom the Lord our God will call." With many other words, he warned them, and he pleaded with them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 were added to their number that day. Marami po. And then in Acts chapter 4, verse 4, mababasa po natin, marami rin po na-convert, 5,000. 5,000 Jews na naging Christian. In Acts chapter 4, verse 4, we will read, "But many who heard the message believed. So the number of men who believed grew to about 5,000. Susunod po, yung Acts chapter 6, verse 7, marami rin po sila, "The great company of priests. So the word of God spread. The number of disciples in Jerusalem increased rapidly, and a large number of priests became obedient to the faith." Next po, sa letter E, Acts chapter 8, verses 12 to 13, yung mga na-convert na Samaritans. "But when they believed Philip, as he proclaimed the good news of the kingdom of God," as Philip yung nag-preach, "in the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. Simon himself believed and was baptized, and he followed Philip everywhere, astonished by the great signs and miracles he saw." Next po sa list, mga kapatid, ay yung Ethiopian eunuch sa Acts chapter 8, verses 34 to 39. Ito yung tinuruan ni Philip. The eunuch asked Philip, "Tell me, please, who is the prophet talking about, himself or someone else?" So, in-explain Philip sa kanya yung passage of scripture and told him the good news about Jesus, the Evangelio. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, here is water. What can stand in the way of my being baptized?" And he gave orders to stop the chariot. Then both Philip and the eunuch went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord suddenly took Philip away, and the eunuch did not see him again, but went on his way rejoicing. So next the list, na na-convert, si Saul of Tarsus. Diba? Kilala po natin siya na naging Apostle Paul. In Acts chapter 9, verses 3 to 6, a soul near Damascus to persecute Christians. A light from heaven suddenly flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice say to him, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" "Who are you, Lord?" Saul asked. "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting," he replied. "Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do." And in Acts chapter 22, verses 12 to 6, we will read, "A man named Ananias came to see me," sabi ni Paul, "and he was a devout observer of the law and highly respected by all the Jews living there. He stood beside me and said, 'Brother Saul, receive your sight.' And at that very moment, I was able to see him. Then he said, 'The God of our ancestors has chosen you to know his will and to see the righteous one and to hear words from his mouth. You will be his witness to all people of what you have seen and heard. And now, what are you waiting for? Get up, be baptized, and wash your sins away, calling on his name.'" And then next on the list, si Cornelius. Cornelius, na-convert siya kasama ang kanyang household. can read the conversion of Cornelius in Acts chapter 10, verses 34 to 44. Also in Acts chapter 15, verses 7 to 8, mababasa natin. After much discussion, Peter got up and addressed them. Brothers, you know that some time ago God made a choice among you that the Gentiles might hear from my lips the message of the gospel and believe. God, who knows the heart, showed that He accepted them by giving the Holy Spirit to them, just as He did to us. So ito po proof that the gospel is for all. Hindi lang siya para sa mga Jews, also for the Gentiles. And in Acts chapter 10, verses 47 to 48, Peter said, "Surely no one can stand in the way of their being baptized with water. They have received the Holy Spirit just as we have." So he ordered that they be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they asked Peter to stay with them for a few days. And then sa letter H, si Lydia. Si Lydia at ang kanyang household na convert, na baptized. In Acts chapter 16, verses 14 to 15, we will read, "One of those listening was a woman from the city of Thyatira, named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth. She was a worshiper of God. The Lord opened her heart to respond to Paul's message. When she and the members of her household were baptized, she invited us to her home. Sabi niya, 'If you consider me a believer in the Lord,' she said, 'come and stay at my house.'" And she persuaded us. Next in the list, mga kapatid, the Philippian jailer. And we can read this in Acts chapter 16, verses 29 to 34. Siya rin at ang kanyang household. "The jailer called for lights, rushed in and fell friendly before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, 'Sirs, what must I do to be saved?' They replied, 'Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household.' Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all the others in his At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Then immediately he and all his household were baptized. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before them. He was filled with joy because he had come to believe in God, he and his whole household." Next on the list, mga kapatid, the Bereans in Acts chapter 17, verses 11 to 12. So marami rin po silang na-convert. The Berean Jews. "Now the Berean Jews were of more noble character than those in Thessalonica, for they received the message with great eagerness." Dahil din po sa Evangelio, ganun po ang nangyari sa mga. "And examined the scriptures every day to see if what Paul said was true. As a result, many of them believed, as did also a number of prominent Greek women and many Greek men." So next on the list, mga kapatid, the Corinthians in Acts chapter 18, verse 8. Marami rin po silang na-convert. Crispus, the synagogue leader, and his entire household believed in the Lord. And many of the Corinthians who heard Paul believed and were baptized. And Ephesians, yung mga Ephesians din po na na-convert sa Acts chapter 19, verses 5 to 7. "On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. There were about 12 men in all." Marami rin po sila baptized. And then next po, the testimony of the apostles. Na magpapatunay na the Holy Spirit saves sinners through the gospel. So unahin po natin si Apostle Paul. Romans chapter 1, verse 16. Ano po yung sinabi ni Apostle Paul? "For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes, first to the Jew, then to the Gentile." Next, sa Romans chapter 10, verses 14 to 17, Apostle Paul wrote, "How then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them?" So, ganito kahalaga, no? If you preach, no? Evangelio para marinig. And how can anyone teach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. But not all the Israelites accepted the good news. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed our message? Consequently, faith comes from hearing the message. And the message is heard through the word about Christ. Also in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 15 to 16, mababasa po natin, even if you had 10,000 guardians in Christ, you do not have many fathers. For in Christ Jesus, I became your father through the gospel. Therefore, I urge you to imitate me, sabi ni Apostle Paul. And in relation to that, mababasa rin po natin sa sinabi ni Paul sa 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 1, sabi niya, follow my example as I follow the example of Christ. Also, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 1 to 2, sinulat po ni Apostle Paul, now, brothers and sisters, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, which you received and on which you have taken your stand. By this gospel, you are saved. If you hold firmly to the word I preached to you. Otherwise, you have believed in vain. So, susunod po si James. Kanyang testimony sa James chapter 1, verses 18 to 22. He chose to give us birth through the word of truth, that we might be a kind of first fruits of all he created. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. Because human anger does not produce the righteousness that God desires. Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word planted in you, which can save you. Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. And last list natin, testimony si Apostle Peter. In 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 22 to 23, we will read, now that you have purified yourselves by obeying the truth, so that you have sincere love for each other, love one another deeply from the heart. For you have been born again, not of perishable seed, but of imperishable, through the living and enduring word of God. And also in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3, Peter wrote, His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and goodness. So for our conclusion, mga kapatid, the answer to the question, how does the Holy Spirit save sinners, is simply, the Holy Spirit saves sinners through the gospel. In John 3, verse 5, ating scripture text reading at the beginning of the sermon, Jesus answered, very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of water and the Spirit. Also in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 23, you can read, For you have been born again, not of seed, which is perishable, but imperishable, that is through the living and enduring word of God. Maganda rin po yung sa Filipino version. Babasahin ko rin. Yamang ipinanganak kayong muli, hindi sa binhing nasisira, kundi sa walang kasirahan. Sa pamamagitan ng salita ng Diyos na nabubuhay at namamalagi. So, if a person wants to have salvation, he or she must accept the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. And in Romans chapter 1, verse 16, we can read, For I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation. Everyone who believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. Maganda rin po yung Filipino version. Sapagkat hindi po ikinahihiya ang Ebanghelyo. Sapagkat siyang kapangyarihan ng Diyos sa ikaliligtas ng bawat sumasampalataya. Unay sa Hudyo at gayon din sa Griyego. So for our invitation, to all of our guests, loved ones, and friends who are here with us today, my question po, have you been convicted, converted, and saved by the Holy Spirit? So you can answer yes only if you believe the Bible and have obeyed God's commandments. So God loves you and doesn't want you to perish. Then po natin sa John chapter 3 verse 16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. So follow the Holy Spirit's word, which is the word of God. Accept His offer of salvation through the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Sinulat na po ni Apostle Paul sa 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3-4. For what I received, I pass on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, that He was buried, He was raised on the third day according to the Scriptures. So after hearing the gospel, all you have to do next is to believe and have faith in our Lord Jesus. You can read in John chapter 8 verse 24, therefore I said to you that you will die in your sins, for if you do not believe that I am He, you will die in your sins. And then repent of your sins. You can read in Acts chapter 17 verse 30, in the past, God overlooked such ignorance, but now He commands all people everywhere to repent. And then you have to confess Christ as the Son of God. You can read in Matthew chapter 10 verses 32-33. Therefore, whoever confesses Me before men, him I will also confess before My Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies Me before men, him I will also deny before My Father who is in heaven. And then, be baptized or immersed for the remission of sin. You can read in Acts chapter 2 verse 38. Then Peter said to them, repent, and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. So, ganito po yung isang example ng baptism, immersion, for the remission of sins. And then, the Lord will add you this church. In Acts chapter 2, verse 47, we will read, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. And then, be faithful to Him until the end, so that the Lord will give you eternal life. Be with Him in heaven for eternity. You can read in Revelation chapter 2 verse 10, be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. Good morning po ulit mga kapatid, and God bless.